John Moffatt as Hercule Poirot and Simon Williams as Captain Hastings in Agatha Christie's Lord Edgware Dies.
It any longer. I killed him and I enjoyed watching the brute die. You don't know him as I did. He wasn't fit to live. You may call me a murderess, but I did mankind a service by ridding the world of him. Hang me if you will, but don't ask me to repent. The day I killed him was the most magnificent day of my life.
Oh, didn't I tell you she was amazing, Poirot? Quite uncanny. The voice, the face, the whole Jane Wilkinson manner to a T. The way she threw back her hair at the end, just the way Jane did it in Dark Horizons.
Miss Adams is a quite remarkable performer, I agree.
And to think you didn't want to come because it was your evening for trimming your moustaches.
It was worth the sacrifice. Thank you, Hastings.
Oh, it wasn't easy getting a table, I can tell you. This is her last night.
Her impersonation of Jane Wilkinson was astonishingly convincing, certainly, but so were her Garbo and her Lady Astor. Tell me, is there a real Carlotta Adams beneath all this?
Well, she's supposed to be a very sweet, modest, ordinary girl, as far as I know. But do you really think impersonation is the right word, Poirot? Hmm? She literally becomes all these people with practically nothing in the way of makeup. When she was doing Dark Horizons, it might have been Jane Wilkinson herself.
Not quite, my friend.
What do you mean?
Look over there. Is not that Jane Wilkinson herself?
Good Lord, so it is.
And the men with her, who has the features of a Greek god.
Well, you must know who that is, Poirot. It's Brian Martin. He was her leading man in Forbidden Desires.
But I thought that Jane Wilkinson gave up acting when she married Lord Edgware.
She did, but now she's given up Lord Edgware and gone back to acting. The marriage can't have lasted more than 2 years, and now she's returning to the West End Theatre. A good thing, if you ask me. She's a magnificent actress.
Perhaps.
What do you mean, perhaps?
If she's the centre of the play, if the play is written for her and about her, then she can be, as you say, magnificent. But she can only play herself. She is interested only in herself. Such women go through life in great danger.
Danger?
Yes, Hastings, danger. Because, you see, a woman like that sees only one thing, herself, and her own forward path. And so, sooner or later, disaster.
Hmm. Well, she seems to be uncommonly interested in you. She hasn't taken her eyes off you for the last couple of minutes. It must be the moustaches. I do believe she's coming over to speak to us.
And I do not think that Monsieur Martin is altogether keen on the idea.
I believe you are Monsieur Hercule Poirot, am I right?
At your service, madame.
Monsieur Poirot, I must talk to you.
Oh, by all means, madame. Pray, sit down with us.
No. I must speak to you privately. I'm sure the drool can find us a quiet room somewhere where we won't be disturbed.
Jane, you can't just whisk Monsieur Poirot off like this.
Don't tell me what I can and cannot do, Brian. Just go back to your table and watch the rest of the show. Monsieur Poirot and I are going to have a little talk, aren't we?
Of course, madame. You permit that my friend Captain Hastings comes with us?
Thank you, Jules. So discreet as always. And a bottle of my favourite champagne. You think of everything.
Well, that be all, madame?
Quite perfect, thank you. It is so good of you to spare me your time like this, Monsieur Poirot.
Tell me, in what way can I be of service to you?
Monsieur Poirot, somehow or other, I've just got to get rid of my husband.
Oh, but madame, getting rid of husbands is not my speciality.
Of course, I know that.
I do not make investigations for divorce. It is not pretty, ce métier-là.
My dear Monsieur Poirot, I'm not asking you to spy at keyholes or talk to chambermaids. I have just got to get rid of the man, and I'm sure you can tell me how to do it.
First, tell me, madame, why you are so anxious to get rid of Lord Edgware.
I want to get married again. What other reason could there be?
But surely he'd give you a divorce.
You don't know my husband, Captain Hastings. He's... I don't know how to put this. He's not like other people.
In what way is he not like other people?
He should never have married anyone. He's obsessed with cruelty. Huh. His first wife ran away from him, leaving her little baby behind her. He never divorced her, and she died miserably abroad somewhere. And then he married me. I simply couldn't stand it. He frightened me. He's a monster. I left him and went off to Hollywood. I've no grounds for divorce, and if I'd given him grounds, he won't take any notice of them. He's a very strange man.
And who is the man you wish to marry?
The Duke of Merton.
Good Lord.
The whole thing is so wonderfully romantic. He's quite unlike anyone I've ever met.
But isn't he a committed Anglo-Catholic?
And Merton Castle is something out of a fairy tale.
But would he still want you to continue...
Captain Hastings, the first thing I shall do when we marry is give up the stage.
And in the meantime, Lord Edgware stands in the way of all these romantic dreams.
Yes, it's driving me to distraction.
So what do you want me to do? After all, every man has the right to live.
Oh, I don't want you to kill him for me.
Oh, I can't tell you how relieved I am, madame.
I thought you might somehow be able to talk him round to the idea of a divorce. I'm sure you could.
I think you rather overestimate my persuasive powers.
Oh, but surely you can think of something. You'd like me to be happy, wouldn't you?
I should like everyone to be happy.
Yes, but I wasn't thinking of everyone. I was thinking of me. You will help me, won't you? I can't tell you...
Pardon me, madame.
Yes, Jules, what is it?
Mr. Martin would like to have a word.
How delightfully formal. Ask him to come in.
I know you didn't want to be disturbed, Jane, but...
I've said what I wish to say to Monsieur Poirot.
I thought that you'd like to know that I've succeeded in the commission you gave me.
Have you indeed? That's wonderful. I'll just fix my face and join you. In the meantime, Monsieur Poirot can think about my proposal.
Well, Monsieur Poirot, has our Jane persuaded you to fight her battles? You might as well give in sooner rather than later. She doesn't understand the word no.
She has not come across it, perhaps.
A very interesting character, Jane. Taboos have no meaning for her. No morals whatever. Oh, I don't mean she's exactly immoral. She isn't. Amoral is the word, I believe. She sees only one thing in life, what Jane wants.
She certainly seems very determined.
I believe she'd kill somebody quite cheerfully and feel injured if they caught her and wanted to hang her for it. The trouble is that she would be caught. She hasn't any brains. Her idea of a murder would be to drive up in a taxi, sail in under her own name and shoot.
Now, I wonder what makes you say that.
But we'd better get back to our table. I wouldn't miss this particular confrontation for the world.
I felt I just had to know you, Miss Adams. It was an utterly fantastic performance.
You're very kind, Lady Edgware. If I'd known you were there tonight, I think I'd have died of fright.
I don't know when I enjoyed anything so much as I did your show tonight.
That's very sweet of you. Oh, and I do appreciate you telling me
so. You'll join us for supper, won't you? And you as well, Monsieur Poirot. Captain Hastings.
I'd love to.
Oh, forgive me, Lady Edgware, but it is long past my bedtime.
But you'll do as I asked.
I will do what I can.
You've got to persuade him. For my sake. If you don't.
What will happen if I don't?
I'll just have to take a taxi and go round and bump him off myself.
Marmalade?
Oh, Hastings, you know I never take marmalade. What are you thinking of?
I was simply trying to get your attention. What is that letter?
See for yourself.
An appointment with Lord Edgware at Regent Gate tomorrow morning.
You are surprised?
Well,
You thought perhaps it was Lady Edgware's champagne that I promised what I would not perform? My friend, the promises of Hercule Poirot are sacred.
But you surely can't let yourself be influenced by...
I am not in the habit of letting myself be influenced by anyone.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.